Hello, children. It's me, Mrs. Gronert again, and I wanted to talk to you again today about using quotation marks and commas. When we think about people talking, we always want to use quotation marks to show where people begin to speak and where they end speaking. We also use commas with those quotation marks. So let's take a look. She said, little froggy, let me enter. Notice after she said, there's a comma. Then we make the quotation marks. Remember, the beginning quotation marks always look like look like little sixes. The ending quotation marks, when the bird finishes talking, look like little nines. So there we go. She said, little froggy, let me enter. Now there are commas in between the words little froggy, because there's a pause when you say it. Little froggy, let me enter. You don't say it, little froggy, let me enter. That would sound really silly. Now let's look at the response. We have, no, you won't enter, not even in the cold of winter, responded the first frog. So you notice, again, when the first frog begins talking, there are quotation marks at the beginning. Then, no, you won't enter, comma, comma, not even in the cold of winter. You see, this response ends with an exclamation point because the froggy is really upset with the bird. Then we look at the final sentence, and the bird responds, then I'll pick and I'll peck and your house I will wreck, said the colorful bird. Notice again, the quotation marks at the beginning of the response look like little sixes. Then, comma, I'll pick, comma, and I'll peck, comma, and your house I will wreck, exclamation point. The ending quotation marks look like little nines. I hope that helps you with your writing. I'd love to see you try to write some sentences using quotation marks and commas today. Thanks. Have a great day. See you soon.